legitimized a morally and politically compromised president of the ANC. We do not recognize him due to his incapacity, lack of direction, association with criminal elements, unaccountability, and pure disregard of the Constitution and the people of South Africa. We are here to speak about a country where more than 26 million of its population live in absolute poverty and suffering. We are here to speak about a country where more than 8 million of its capable workforce cannot find jobs because the state under its current leadership cannot provide jobs. We are here to speak about the many capable children who do not have access to quality and free education because the state cannot provide free quality education for all. However, we are comforted by the militant structures like Fees Must Fall movement, Roads Must Fall movement, and the EFF Student Command because they are keeping the dream of decolonization and free education alive. We must not forget that we are in a country where black majority, more than 80% of the population, is congested and squeezed in less than 20% of the land because the rest of the land is owned and controlled by those who colonially took it from the African majority through committing black genocide. We must not forget that we are in a country where settler colonialist and white monopoly capital is in control of almost all sectors of the economy. The white minority own and control every section of the economy, including the maize mill, which feeds majority of our people because the former liberation movement betrayed its founding principles. We must not forget that we are in a country where African majority continue to be slaves and suppliers of cheap labor to the white minority as cleaners, garden boys, domestic workers, car guards, petrol attendants, security guards, and rock drill operators, and everything that pays low wages. The ANC has destroyed the nursing, teaching,